So do you like Italian? I know I do. Who doesn't like Italian? Wait, I can think of someone who doesn't.
You guys like Italian?
No.
Yes.
Yeah,
no.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes. I love Italian. And so do you.
Yes.
And so do you. Once again to Cooking Under the Influence with me, your host and chef de giorno. I'm Sean, as you probably already know. Today on Cooking Under the Influence, we have sort of an experiment going on. Let me show you. My neighbor grew these in his vegetable garden. They are called caguzzas, or Italian squash. You remember my comment about the cucumber in the sushi episode? I can't even go there with these. I have no idea how to cook these. I had to pull a bunch of friends to ask. But before we start cooking, as all good chefs know, we need a drink. All this stuff goes in today's drink. Salt, pepper, Worcestershire, beans, horseradish. What the hell kind of a drink has all that stuff? You making soup? Close. We're making Bloody Marys. I'm going to start off with some V8 juice. You can use tomato juice. Take a little bit of pepper. Dash of salt, Worcestershire sauce, or Worcester sauce, if you're in England, horseradish, and vodka. Oh, you know what else we can put in there? Some Tabasco sauce. A little bit of ice. Oh, look, we still have room. Yay. And get your spicy beans. Some people put celery or okra, pickled okra, which is great. I happen to have beans, so we're going to do beans. Mix it up nicely. Everybody thinks this is related to Mary, Queen of Scots, Bloody Mary. It's not. It was handed down to us from the ancient druids. Okay. Great drink to nurse a hangover. Hair of the dog that bit you. Dang, I can make a good Bloody Mary. Not that I would ever get hungover. Right? Caguzzas. Let's make a marinara. I'm not about to peel tomatoes and seed tomatoes. We're just gonna use a nice pre-made thing. I'm gonna rinse out our jars. We get all that goodness with vodka. Never cook with any vodka. You wouldn't drink it a Bloody Mary. I'm gonna get a can of tomato paste. Tomato paste. I suppose if you're like short on tomato paste, you could use like ketchup or something. Please don't use ketchup, Jesus. Oh, that would just be blasphemy. Apparently, a hallmark of Italian foods and sauces is splatterability. Do this, it goes every freaking where. Tomato. I'm gonna add a little bit of chicken stock to this. Now, as you know, I am no fool when it comes to making sauce, so we're gonna chop up some real tomatoes. Now, the Italians are well known for many of the things that they brought to the world. For example, they gave us pasta. Oh, wait, no, that was the Chinese. Well, they gave us pizza.
Human skin, ripped t-shirt, whatever the hell, pizza.
No, that was the ancient Mayans.
And tell me that that doesn't look like the frickin' Mayan calendar. Totally.
Oh, I know, the Roman Empire and the papacy. Oh, wait, no, that was the Turks.
Istanbul was Constantinople, now it's Istanbul, now Constantinople, been a long time gone, Constantinople now.
Well, the Italians gave us Ferraris. Did you know I've got a Ferrari, like, sitting out in my driveway right now? Sure I do. I'm doing it the ghetto way. Just seeds, peel, and everything. I'm not peeling any damn tomatoes or taking the seeds out. You Italian grandmas, y'all can do that.
We're gonna get us some thyme and basil from the garden. Great stuff.
Try and get it actually in the pot. All right, you remember how to make a roulade of basil leaves? Then you need to go back and research my old videos. Roulade, oh ho ho! And we're just gonna simmer it way down. Oh, cheeks. Oh, and don't forget to add like your miscellaneous spices. Put some oregano in there. Bit of salt. I'm gonna get some peppers that I got out of my garden also. Alright, unless you're like Mr. Danger, like me, wear some latex gloves when you're handling these things because they are deadly hot. Plenty garlic. And some fresh ground pepper. Alright, as you'll note, none of this has anything to do with the caguzzas, the Italian squash. This is phase one of the cooking process.
Alright, now you can see that it's pretty thin. So we're gonna let that sit for a while. We're gonna let it simmer.
And letting it simmer is the best part of making sauce because it takes a few hours, which gives you plenty of time for more Bloody Marys. And to clean up your boob sweat. They're gross. Some number of Bloody Mary. What is this? The marinara. I was doing marinara earlier.
Okay, remember how thin it was before? And now it's nice and thick and tomatoey. And there's no ketchup in there.
Where the hell's my drink? Oh, here it is. Now the hard part comes. We have to do these things, the Italian squash. Fucking peel it. Where's my vegetable peeler? I'm gonna try a couple different things in here. Big old damn pot. Oh, let's put some water. And these recipes come to me courtesy of my good Italian friend, Maria. And my not Italian friend, Samantha. Well, she might be Italian, I don't know. I haven't delved into her DNA history and racial profile and all that. I'm just gonna make some little medallions or kichen. This caguzza, I'm just gonna stick in the marinara and it can just simmer. All right, now apparently there's some controversy over what to do with the caguzzas, whether they're tough or tender. I don't know how to gauge the tenderness of a Italian squash. You know, you do meatballs and spaghetti? We're just using caguzza. That's it. So if you're a vegetarian, you can be all about this. Vodka, and that's made from potatoes. I don't know if they have a squash liquor. That would be interesting. Gone is the zombie hair. Now I've got this kind of military flat top thing going on. Because I'm so pretty. Yeah, I look real pretty after I've been drinking a bunch of freaking Bloody Marys. Anybody looks pretty after that. The only thing about Bloody Marys is it's like soup. So it's kind of filling. Which means you could pretty much live off of Bloody Marys. That's not a bad idea. I'm just going to steam these caguzzas. I think I just like saying caguzza. That's a fun word. I mean, you could feed a family in, you know, Ghana for a year off of one of these things. Ooh. You should taste your food before you serve it. Dang, that's good. This white Irish boy can cook some freaking Italian food. By the way, if you have something you think I should cook, put it in the comments below. A bunch of people want me to cook freaking frog legs. Slicing up an onion. All right, this is really simple. Slice up the squash, slice up the onions. Now we're just gonna put a little butter, salt, and pepper. Butter is a summer surfactant. Yeah, we'll go with that. All right, this is not gonna be, Christ, with the plastic wrap, come on, really? Friggin' plastic wrap. Very difficult plastic wrap. And put it in the microwave. Dump it out. Ow! Motherfucker! God damn, that's hot. Prepare yourself with your containment equipment. Bloody Marys make shit so much easier to deal with. I'll bet you anything that the Pope has like 12 Bloody Marys for breakfast. I mean, if you had to deal with a billion screaming Catholics, wouldn't you need a few Bloody Marys for breakfast? Holy crap. No, I guess it's better than dealing with a billion screaming Protestants. Oh, Lord. One of the recipes I got is to make like a pasta sort of deal out of the caguzza. You know how to do spaghetti squash? You get a spaghetti squash, you scrape it up, Let's try that with the caguzza. This is not working. This is just mush. That is like disgusting. Lisa, I love you, but it's like not working. So let's make some spaghetti. Fortunately, I have like several linear yards of caguzza to waste. It's America, you can waste it. Now, if you're a vegetarian, you know how to make spaghetti squash, because that's like one of those vegetarian things. Or a vegan thing. Oh, Christ, are you going to start me on the goddamn vegans again? What the hell is that? Oh my God. It's like a big chunk of wood. This is like what they nailed Jesus to the cross with. Holy crap. That must have been in the jar of stuff. I feel a giant lawsuit coming on. This is a chunk of wood. Oh shit, it's just my spatula. It's split because I left it in the thing. Now, if I have vampires, this will be very handy. All over the damn place. Okay, marinara looks awesome. Here's your marinara, nice and thick with the caguzzas all cooked up in it. Yummy. Pasta, all boiling. All right, here's our caguzzas with the onions and butter and salt and pepper. How do you know when pasta's done? Some people throw it against the wall. That is not my preferred method of decoration. Take it. That's pretty al dente. Al dente means to the bite. Right, have you ever had pasta Italian, like Italian pasta in actually Italy? They just give you pasta with a little bit of olive oil and maybe some salt and pepper. And it is awesome. But here in America, of course, we have to put shit on it. We have a nice plate of pasta, caguzza marinara on top of there. We're going to take our microwave caguzza, onions. There we go, our Italian feast with caguzza. There's a lot of light in here, so it's hard to see. So that's our caguzza episode, Italian shit. Buon appetito, and adios. Send me some suggestions in the comments below.